الحمد لله، جعل شهر رمضان سيد الشهور أفاض فيه الخير والنور، سبحانه يغفر الذنوب ويستر العيوب ويغيث المكروب وهو علام الغيوب، أما فضله الأكوان ويقبل التوبة وينزل الرحمة في كل زمان ومكان. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، فرض علينا الصيام تهذيبا للنفوس وتقوى للقلوب بقوله: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. اللهم اجعل في بصرنا نورا، وفي سمعنا نورا، وفي قلبنا نورا. اللهم اشرح لنا صدورنا ويسر لنا أمورنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من وساوس الصبر وشتات الأمر وشر فتنة ما يلج في الليل وشر ما يلج في النهار وشر ما تهب به الرياح وشر بواق الدهر. وأشهد أن سيدنا وقائدنا وشفيعنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله الصادق الأمين، غفر الله له ذنبه وشرح له صدره ووضع عنه وزره ورفع له ذكره، فكان مجدا وأكثر ما يكون ذلك في رمضان، وكان مجتهدا وأكثر ما يكون ذلك في رمضان، وكان كريما وأكثر ما يكون ذلك في رمضان، وكان جوادا وأكثر ما يكون ذلك في رمضان، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Muslims around the world, they are ready for the last 10 days of Ramadan. In the last 10 days of Ramadan, just in a day or two, that the last 10 days will start, had a special preparations for Muslims and the special worships, and that indicates that the night of decree, Laylatul Qadr, is going to be in one of these nights, especially the odd nights. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when reached these 10 days of Ramadan, he will do i'tikaf. I'tikaf in the masjid, and going to dedicate all his time for prayer, supplication, remembrance Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He usually used to do i'tikaf in the 10 days, in the last 10 days of Ramadan. But in his last year before, after that he died, he made i'tikaf for 20 days. Month of Ramadan is moving fast and passing quickly. So the Muslims has to take advantage of that, because in Ramadan is an opportunity for forgiveness of the sins. So not to let this opportunity to go without maximizing the benefits and rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The benefits of Ramadan, and especially in the last 10 days, is when you perfect your fasting. That's a way to for forgiveness of your sins. When you perfect your prayers and supplication, also it's a way for forgiveness. And also when you attend the Laylatul Qadr, praying, supplicating, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this will equal 83 years. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he looked at the ages of his ummah, which is us, and comparing to the ages of previous nations, our ages will be less than the ages of the previous nations. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this opportunity to maximize our deeds. For that one night only, when you worship Allah in one night, you equal to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 83 years. So this is the reason that, and also that night was not clearly defined, but it is made within the last 10 days of Ramadan, and also within the odd nights, the 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, and the 29th. So for the people to maximize their prayers, supplications, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to match that night and to get the reward. So we'll mention that inshallah. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was doing the prayers and the fasting, and he was doing the maximum of that during the month of Ramadan. Also he used to wake up in the last 10 days of Ramadan. He used to wake up his family and encourage them to do the prayer and to do the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to knock the door of Ali and Fatima and ask him, I'm going to go to do prayers. And also he used to wake up his family, like his wives, to do the prayer too. So in doing i'tikaf during this time and dedicating all the time for worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the specific tasks during this last 10 days of Ramadan that you maximize it, it's not like any other night, is to pray more, to pray Taraweeh, to pray Qiyam, and also to have the people around you to do the same, to maximize their rewards also, because that's what will come back on you. Remind people with the prayer all the time, and that's also when you remind somebody with something, you get the reward of them without minimizing their rewards. And also, during this time, it's to make sure that you have your futur and your suhoor, so this way you'll be strong to do the worshiping at night more than usual, and by this way you will be able to continue and to continue to the end, because this is something that you need to continuity is a key for maximizing the reward that you want to get. Also, being clean. Not only that, the Muslims in the companion used to clean themselves for within this 10 days, like they clean themselves as they go to Jum'ah, because and also especially in the Laylatul Qadr, they wear the best clothes they have, they put the perfume that they have, and they not only maximizing their cleanness, appearance, cleansing clothes and perfume and being purified, and also purifying their hearts, because you cannot just purify your body and your clothes and your heart is not clean. That's not is not going to work. So you have to make both works. Purifying your hearts, have no bad feeling toward the other people. Make sure that you make a peace between people, that you may have some conflict, and by this way you will have both cleanness in the heart and the cleanness in the body. And then, as I mentioned, staying in the masjid or doing i'tikaf. This i'tikaf could be for hours sometimes. When you go to the masjid, you do i'tikaf and the prayer. But when you are in i'tikaf, you cannot do anything else except to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reciting Quran. By this way, your continuity in i'tikaf will guarantee your rewards. In Ramadan, there is a certain things that you can do for you to get the forgiveness of the sins. Forgiveness of the sins, first of all, when you fast Ramadan, when you pray at night, and especially Laylatul Qadr, this way you will guarantee the forgiveness. As I mentioned, three things you get the forgiveness: the fasting, the prayer, and attending the Laylatul Qadr, not to miss it. So especially, so from the last 10 days of Ramadan, you need to keep doing the best for you to match that night, because it's not clearly, although some people, they say the 27th, but it is even could be from 1 year 27th, another year 25th. So the best thing is from the last 10 of days of Ramadan, just to do your best and worship continuously, non-stop. Do not differentiate between night and night. So when you do the prayers, do it right, because if you don't do it right, that's not going to be perfect. It's not going to be complete. And also when you do the siyam, the fasting, also do it right. And to do the siyam right, you have to follow the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to keep your fasting complete with no discrepancies. So when you just perfect, yes, your goal is to perfect your prayer, to perfect your fasting, to perfect your worship, and not only that, and also you, when you do all this, the most important thing is to seek acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because many people, they may do things, but their work is not accepted. So even some scholars or the companion, they worry about the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the work more than doing the worship itself. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for acceptance even more than or equal to the worship itself. So that's very, very important. It's the most important thing is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept. This is what we always ask and supplicate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, this is very easy worship that you can do by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You didn't have to be in a wudu. You didn't have to be standing or sitting. You can remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a form of standing, walking, sitting, sleeping. You worship, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. And making istighfar also all the time, non-stop. You can do it while you're driving, while you're walking, while you're sitting. There are certain things, alhamdulillah, that you can do with no much preparation, in advance to do it. Like as I mentioned about the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this will also bring to you the istighfar wal malaika. The angels will make istighfar for you when you keep on making istighfar, when you keep on remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you and with his angels, with his creation there. So, and you could imagine what kind of honor that you're going to get with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you remember him, he will remember you. So this is something that also to keep in mind, and also the angels will pray for you when you keep remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this is what the angels will do. They will remember you and they will pray for you. So Ramadan is a month that you can free yourself from the hellfire. And this is the last 10 days of Ramadan. This is the last 10 days that you can free yourself from the hellfire. From the hellfire. This ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free you from the hellfire. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free slaves from the hellfire. And this last 10 days more than any other time, and especially at the end of the last 10 days more than any other time. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free us from the hellfire and also will keep us in the paradise, for those are in the paradise without any previous punishment. There's four things if you keep them in mind all the time. And these four things, they are not really hard to do. One thing is to say al-shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, all the time. Just to repeat that. Because ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, will wipe off sins. That will clear your record from the bad record. That you, as you want to clean your record as you go, just keep saying ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, by itself. And also make more istighfar all the time. More istighfar going to clear your bad sins for along the way as you move. So la ilaha ashhadu la ilaha illallah, and make istighfar. That's going to be something. It's your weapon. That's going to be your way to attack these kind of deficiencies that you have in your life, because this is going to be ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon you. to not pardon you better than forgive you, because pardon you will wipe out completely the record of the sins. But forgiveness is going, the sins will be there, but it's going to be forgiven. So always Allah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for pardon you. Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun tuhibb al-afu fa'afu anna al-afu. Pardon al-afu. Allahumma innaka afuun kareem tuhibb al-afu fa'afu anna. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon you from the sins. This way your record will be clear. And also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the paradise. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take you to the paradise without previous accounting. Just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the final words. He can take you to the paradise for right away. And also, استعيذ بالله من النار. That to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you away from the hellfire. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take you to the paradise, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you away from the hellfire. So you have ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna rasulullah, make istighfar, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for paradise, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you away from the hellfire. These things say that you will free yourself from the hellfire, you will have forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's going to vanish all the sins, is going to wipe all the sins. And so nothing more than that. You're going in the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have la ilaha illallah in one scale and all sins in another scale, la ilaha illallah will be heavier. So repeat la ilaha illallah as many times as you can, so for that to be in your record, and that to be for, because in the day of judgment, when the person will come, had a lot of sins, and then he was almost going to the hellfire, but you will know, wait, and then that cart of La ilaha illallah will come, and as soon as put in the scale, La ilaha illallah will be heavier, and then he will be going to the paradise. So maximize that saying Allah, La ilaha illallah, for that will be our rescue in the day of the judgment, because don't underestimate such small words that you say, La ilaha illallah, but it is, the rewards of it is nobody knows the greatness of the words except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you maximize that during the months of Ramadan, when you are fasting, that's going to even more, will be more acceptable than in other times. So during the fasting, your prayer, your supplication will be accepted during the day, and also before you make iftar. So you always remember to supplicate, because when you do that, your sins will be wiped off, and you will be forgiven. So أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله عسى أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. As I mentioned, the night of decree, the Laylatul Qadr, in the last 10 days of Ramadan, that's a night that you watch to fulfill, to fast well, to pray at night, and to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's a night that was honored. Its rank is more than any other night. And as I mentioned, when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will get the reward of 83 years of worshiping, and there are lots of characteristics in that night. So first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran in that night. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. It even has one surah, one chapter in its name, ليلة القدر. سورة القدر. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر. سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. So in the name of Allah, the most beneficent and the most merciful, verily we have sent it, that's Quran, down in the night of Al-Qadr, the decree, and what will make you know what is the night of decree is, the night of Al-Qadr decree is better than 1,000 months. That worship in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that night is better than worshiping Him 1,000 months. I'm sorry, 1,000 months, which is equal 83 years and 4 months. Therein descend the angels and the ruh with the Jibreel by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permission with all decrees, peace. All that night there is peace and goodness from Allah to His believing slaves until the appearance of dawn. So, Laylatul Qadr has indication. It is lots of blessings in Laylatul Qadr. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ مُبَارَكَةِ. So we descend it in a blessed night. That's Laylatul Qadr. And the angels and Angel Jibreel will ascend, and this angel will come with the prosperity and blessings for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala slaves. And also this has peace. This night has peace only. Salamun hiya hatta matla al fajr. There is no shaitan, no devils. And all the devils are tied, and it has peace, because the angels come down with supplicating for believers, and the rewards will come to them. فيها يفرق كل أمر حكيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has in the lawh al-mahfuz all the destinies, the provisions, the ages, and the goodness, and everything what's written on in the slaves is that in Lawh al-Mahfuz, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will has all this in Laylatul Qadr for the following year. So this means that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you from the good receivers of the best you for yourself. And because all these things is destined at this night. So when you pray that night, and you pray, you fast that day, and you pray at night, and your sins going to be forgiven. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه. If you pray and if you fast, Laylatul Qadr, إيمانا واحتسابا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you all the previous sins you have. So إيمانا means that you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards. And احتسابا, and mean that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the rewards without any showing off. And also, as I mentioned before, also this is the whole chapter. It's in the name of this Laylat al-Qadr, Surah al-Qadr, and it's known. This Laylat al-Qadr is in the month of Ramadan, and Laylat al-Qadr in the last 10 days of Ramadan, and also the indication that it is in this night, so it is 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, 29th, could be different in year after year. And even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam فَلْيَتَحَرُّهَا فِي السَّبْعَ الْأَوَاخِرِ, and even some scholars say it is in the night of the 27th. But the best thing is to seek it throughout the last 10 days. There's a wisdom out of hiding the date, so you could maximize your worship throughout these 10 days. There's some indications for that night. They say the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated that indications. The first one is ليلة القدر طلقة لا حارة ولا باردة تصبح الشمس يومها حمراء ضعيفة. It's mean that night it was be like a cool night. There is no, it's not hot and it's not cold, and the sun, when the sun come out, will be no rays. It will be like an open light, that's no rays out of the sun. The second indication, the hearts of the believers will be being optimistic, being feeling good about everything and what they worship. Has peace, and also there is no wind at that night. It's very calm, and also another indication: the sun will not come out, as I mentioned, with no rays. So it would be just very clear. لا شعاع لا حد كأنها حلت حتى ترتفع. So the sun will come without rays at this time. So during this time, the best thing is to mention, make tahajjud, make i'tikaf, always repeat that saying. When Aisha radiallahu anha asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam what to say that night, say Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afw, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon you, and this is the best thing to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afw fa'fu anna. So now, as I mentioned, with this, the month of Ramadan will end just right after that. So the people need to make sure that even if they did not do well in the beginning, this is an opportunity. This is a great opportunity, because you don't know if the next, may Allah give us a long age in good deeds, but you don't know if it's Ramadan, next Ramadan will come and we're still alive. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to maximize our reward during this month and during these 10 days. You know, there's a very well-known words that someone who's stated about Shahr Ramadan, and the asking, even the address Shahr Ramadan as a entity, and they ask him to slow down, because the people cry at this time for the Ramadan. People feel like they're missing, like there's a guest that was about welcome, one of the best guests that you have, and they come quickly and leave quickly, and they're going to feel the pain of leaving, because if you didn't know if he's going to come back again and you're still alive, and asking for forgiveness, and asking to be surrounded with good companions. So may Allah accept our prayers and our fasting. اللهم اجعلنا ممن صام الشهر وأدرك ليلة القدر وفاز بالثواب الجزيل والأجر. اللهم وفقنا لاغتنام الخيرات وضاعف لنا في الدرجات، واجعلنا ممن غنم في هذا الشهر أوفر الحظ والنصيب، إنك سميع مجيب يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي الصلاة حي الفلاح، كبرت الصلاة كبرت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
استقيموا رحمكم الله. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
الرحمن الرحيم. إلى في قريش إلى فيهم أحمد الشتاء. الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر
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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا سبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر